Buhay, this is Mr. Criminology at welcome sa ating mga pag-aaral tungkol sa mga subject matters and discipline of criminology. And this is for the research of the criminology students, for the review of the future registered criminologist, and for the refresher of the registered criminologist. For this lesson, I want to discuss to you the Positivist School of Thought or the Positivist Theory and the Holy Three in Criminology, which are Cesare Lombroso, Enrico Ferri, and Rafaelle Garofalo. And let me begin with explaining the key points of the Positivist School of Criminology. Number one, the term positivism refers to a method of analysis based on the collection of observable scientific facts. Remember, this positivism is a game changer in the study of criminology. This is commonly known as the modern way of explaining crimes and criminals during this time, because before, Cesare Becarria, under the classical school of criminology, they believed that their focus must be the crime. That's why they are punishing people who are committing crime based on free will, and they are more concerned about crime. But here, they began to realize that they must be focusing on the people, on the criminal, and to study why they are committing a criminal act. And that's why their analysis, their method used here under positivism, are based on the collection of observable scientific facts. So their approach is scientific. That's why it is modern way of explaining criminality. Positivists believe also that causes of behavior can be measured and observed. It demands the four facts that scientific proof, thus changing the study of crimes and criminals into scientific approach. So they are not guessing, they are not merely giving their opinion here, but their scientific approach in dealing with the criminals and to explain why they acted that way. Positivist theories were the first to claim the importance of looking at individual differences among criminals. Before we are defining a crime generally, we are giving classifications to criminals generally, but here there is a there are a specific approach, and there are individual differences among criminals that they believe, because there are different nurturing, different orientation, different background, and different beliefs. And of course, because this is a scientific approach, they believe in biology and environmental factors. So they are looking into the individual differences of criminals so that they can also deal individually. They can give intervention individually. These theories were concentrated on the individual structures of a person. So here we can see now that they are dealing a person by biological approach. It stated that people are passive and controlled, whose behaviors are imposed upon them by biological and environmental factors. So here, we can see that in order to study a criminal, let's look into his or her biological composition and what factors in his environment that triggers or that contribute or that causes him to commit a crime. So we also have here Auguste Comte. He was a French philosopher and sociologist as well. And he's believed to be the one who reinvented the French term sociology. So that's why by reinventing the term sociology with IE in the last part, he was recognized as the father of sociology and positivism. But let's focus now on the unholy tree of criminology. They are calling them the holy tree of criminology. But of course, only God is holy, so others calling them unholy tree of criminology or the holy trio of criminology. So they are Cesare Lombroso, we have Enrico Ferri, and you also have Rafaelle Garofalo. Let's see one by one what are their contributions and what are their focus of study under this positivist criminology. Let's have Cesare Lombroso. He was recognized as the father of modern and empirical criminology. Why? Because due to its application of modern scientific methods to trace criminal behavior, however, most of his ideas are now discredited. Although many sociologists and other criminologists discredited, they conducted study to, what do you call this? They want to reprove, they want to correct the studies of Lombroso, but it was still considered as until today as the father of modern criminology because he was the first prominent personality to approach crime scientifically. He was the first person to deal on crime using scientific methods. That's why still he was recognized with that title. Now for the concept of atavistic stigma. So that term coined by or was proposed by Cesare Lombroso, the physical features of creatures at an earlier stage of development. So this is the evolutionary throwback. We have the word atavism. This is going back to the ape-like ancestor. So if there are evolution, these are the people who failed to evolve according to them. He claimed that criminals are distinguishable from non-criminals due to the presence of atavistic stigmata and crimes committed by those who are born with certain recognizable hereditary traits. So, as Lombroso studied criminals using scientific approach, he used biology and Charles Darwin was his cousin. That's why his study has the touch of evolution. And that's where the atavism came from with that approach. The criminal believed that they failed to evolve. And with that, they are distinguishable characteristics that we can recognize which are hereditary in nature. According to his theory, criminals are usually in possession of huge jaw. Number one, they also have strong canine teeth. And their arm span of the criminal is often greater than their height. Just like the apes who are used with their forearms to push themselves along the ground. So those are the characteristics that if a person possess, he was believed to be a born criminal. Other physical stigmata includes the deviation in head size and shape. That's why under positivism, there are also, we have phrenology, the study of the shape of skull that we will be discussing in the near future, the craniology, and asymmetry of the face, excessive dimension of the jaw and the cheekbones. We have eye defects and peculiarities, ears of unusual sizes, nose twisted, upturned or flattened in tibs, or aquiline, or break-like in murderers, fleshy lips, swollen and protruding. We have pouches in the cheek with those of the animal toes. Those are the physical head, facial characteristics of those who are believed to be born criminal under Lombroso's work. Moreover, the work of Lombroso supported the idea that criminal are was a biologically and physically inferior person. Why? According to him, there are three classes of criminals. Number one, there are born criminals. If you are an individual with at least five atavistic stigmata that I mentioned a while ago, you are born criminal. While insane criminals are those who became criminal because of some brain defects, incurring mental illnesses which affected their ability to understand and differentiate the right from wrong, that's why they're committing criminality. They are insane criminals. And number three, they have their criminaloids, those with makeup of an ambiguous group that includes habitual criminals, criminals by fashion, and other diverse types. Others are defining the habitual and the criminal by passion as separated from the criminaloids. But criminaloids also was known as those who are committing crimes due to less physical stamina. And we also have now the second personality in the Holy Tree of Criminology. We have Enrico Ferri. Enrico Ferri, his focus in studying criminal was is greatly influences of the psychological factors and also sociological factors. If Lombroso focus on biology, hereditary, but on the other hand, Enrico Ferri focus on psychology and sociology, such as economics and on crime factors. Those are the field of his study. He also believed that criminals could not be held morally responsible because they did not choose to commit crimes, but rather were driven to commit crimes by conditions in their lives. There are some factors in their lives, economically, sociologically, psychologically, that pushes them to commit criminality. And the third personality is Rafaelle Garofalo. He treated the roots of criminals or the criminals' behavior not to physical features as Lombroso, but their psychological equivalent, which he referred as to a moral anomalies. He rejected the doctrine of free will that held by the classical school of criminology. Classified criminals as murderers, violent criminals, deficient criminals, and lascivious criminals. Also, to add, Rafaelle Garofalo was known for coining the term criminologia. And later, Paul Topinard coined the word criminology with IE until the word English word criminology was born. So we are coining, or we are giving the credit to Rafaelle Garofalo for coining the word criminologia and later evolved to criminology. So far, those are the prominent personalities in positivist criminology, and those are the views, the prominent points that the positivist is teaching us, their contributions in the field of criminology. To end, as the classical school of criminology focused on crime, later on, the neoclassical, a little bit focusing on the criminal, appreciating now that we must focus on person a little bit because they are regarded a child and a lunatic to be exempted from criminal responsibility. And now, the focus was turned into criminals. That's why they are now looking into the biological, sociological, and psychological factors that triggers a person to commit a crime or that cause a person to commit a crime. Soon, we will be discussing more theories, more approach, more field in the theories of crime causation. Hope you learned something. Kindly subscribe, like, and share, and comment down below so that many will benefit to this video. Thank you very much. Jesus saves, and to God be the glory.